Right friends, welcome back to Insight. This is 11th week from 14th March to 20th March. We have 5 issues for this week. For the second year in a row, that means consecutively for 2 years, an opposition-sponsored amendment to the motion of thanks on the President's address was adopted by the Rajya Sabha. I would like to explain a bit about this. President addresses both the Houses of Parliament together, both Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha together, after each general election. Not only that, before first session of each year, right? So first session is normally budget session. So before budget session, not only that, after each general election, that means once in 5 years general elections are held. So after each general election, President addresses both the Houses of Parliament together, and the President's address is first approved by the Union Cabinet. That means the President's address technically prepared by the government, and it indicates government's policies and programs. And it is customary thing to move motion of thanks, and the motion of thanks is normally passed on President's address, right? So in Rajya Sabha, all of you are well aware, in Rajya Sabha, BJP is in minority. Congress and the UPA and other parties put together have got a majority. And because of no consensus between government and opposition, in Rajya Sabha this year and last year, the opposition moved amendments to the motion of thanks. Normal convention is to adopt the motion of thanks unanimously, that is as per the established conventions, and then if amendments are moved and passed in Lok Sabha, then the government has to resign. But amendments, when they are moved and passed in Rajya Sabha, they may not have any effect on government, but it is against established conventions. It indicates that there is no consensus between government and opposition. And for this amendments, both the ruling party and opposition are blaming each other. And if you look at the parliament's history, it occurred only 5 times. And for the first time, it occurred in 1980. When Indira Gandhi was the Prime Minister, on the issue of engineering or promoting defections, and in the year 1989 when Vishwanath Pratap Singh was the Prime Minister. Please don't forget, this normally happens when the opposition has got majority in Rajya Sabha. And please don't forget, if the amendments are passed in Lok Sabha, then the government has to resign, normally, which will not happen. That means passing amendments in Lok Sabha never arise, because the Prime Minister is the leader of the ruling party or ruling coalition, which normally enjoy majority. But Rajya Sabha, it may not happen. Rajya Sabha opposition may have majority, because Rajya Sabha is a continuous house, retiring part of the members once in 2 years. Right, next, if you look at it, in 2001 it happened when Atal Bihari Vajpayee was the Prime Minister with regard to sale of public sector undertaking BALCO to a private company, and consecutively in 2015, basically with regard to amendments on issue of black money. And this year in 2016, legislation passed by BJP governments in Rajasthan and Haryana limiting the right of people to contest panchayat elections. All of you are well aware, Haryana and Rajasthan governments passed legislations to limit the right of people to contest panchayat elections by putting some conditions like minimum educational qualifications. And the amendments in 2016 are with regard to the legislations passed by some states. Whatever it is, the amendments on motion of thanks on the President's address is not in the right spirit, and it is normally against the established conventions, and it indicates there is not much consensus between government and the opposition. Look at the next issue, small savings interest rates slashed substantially. Recently, government reduced the interest rates of small savings substantially. And in some cases, it is up to almost 1.3%. And even the Senior Citizens Savings Scheme as well as Sukanya Samruddhi were also reduced drastically by 0.7% and 0.6%. Why the government reduced small savings interest rates? And normally, any country transitioning from developing country into developed country, the interest rate structure will reduce. That is the fundamental point. For developing countries, the interest rate structure may be somewhere around 6%, 7%, 8% or 5%. But if you look at any developed country like United States of America, Japan and Western European countries, the interest rate structure is normally around 1% or 0.5% or 2% or 3%. So transition towards a lower interest regime is almost has to take place one time or the other. And if you look into the circumstances of slashing these interest rates drastically this time, little bit, we have to go back to history. During 2015, RBI reduced repo or reverse repo rates by 1.25%. Repo rate was reduced in phases from 8% to 6.75%. Repo rate means it gives indication about the lending rates in the banking sector. When repo rate is reduced, then banks normally reduce the lending rates. As RBI reduced repo rates, banks have to reduce lending rates. If banks are reducing lending rates, then their yield will reduce. Then banks have to reduce deposit rates. So here you should understand a little bit more. I am introducing this term yield. Yield means that is the average interest banks are getting on their loans. And in the banking system, please don't forget, assets are loans or loans are assets. When banks are giving loans, the average interest they get is average yield. When banks reduce interest rates, what will happen? Yield will reduce. When yield is reduced, what will happen? Then banks have to reduce deposit rates so as to reduce cost of funds. Please look into this slide. Cost of funds or average cost of funds is the average interest banks pay on their deposits. So as to reduce average cost of funds, then deposit rates are to be reduced. Then only banks will have sufficient net interest margin. For the profitability of the banks, net interest margin of around 3% is must. And net interest margin is basically the difference between average yield and average cost of funds. So the fundamental point which I would like to tell you is, banks are required to reduce the lending rates, and so as to reduce lending rates, they have to reduce deposit rates. When they are required to reduce deposit rates, then what will happen? They will be at a disadvantageous position in comparison to small savings. That's why government reduced small savings rates. Let me make you clear once again. When banks reduce deposit interest rates, then if small savings interest rates are not reduced, then what will happen? Banks will be in a disadvantageous position because people will deposit their money in small savings instead of banks. So banks will lose deposits. That's why, so as to correct this anomaly, now the government reduced small savings rates substantially so as to keep the interest rates on small savings at par with bank deposit rates. No one will be at a disadvantageous position. That is the main purpose of reducing this small savings interest rates. Right. The other important point is, overall, the strategy is to move towards a lower interest rate regime. In a lower interest rate regime, what will happen? More credit offtake will be there and more growth will be there. So if you look at it in a nutshell, the first point is, it is accepted practice to link interest rates on small savings to the returns on government securities. Government securities, the returns are around 7% to 7.5%. G-Secs, all of you are clear about treasury bills. All of you are clear about long-term dated government securities. The interest rates normally vary from 7 to 7.5%. So, it is a normal practice to link the interest rates of small savings with government securities. That is first point. Second point is, as we have already discussed, if the small savings interest rates are high, then what will happen? People will not deposit in banks and people will move towards small savings. Banks will be in disadvantageous position. So, as to remove that anomaly, government now reduced the rates of small savings. Third important point is, lower interest rate regime is a must to steer the economy towards efficient growth path. And the last important point is, this is required to ensure the strategy of low interest rate, low lending rate, more credit offtake, more GDP and prosperous country. So, as to realize the dream of prosperous country, lower interest rate regime is a must, and this time it was reduced drastically, and the drastic reduction in small savings is to be viewed in this perspective. Right, friends, look at the next one. Federal Reserve kept its policy rates unchanged. There is a lot of talk that United States Federal Reserve, you may ask Federal Reserve, what is Federal Reserve? Federal Reserve is basically like our central bank. We have Reserve Bank of India for us, just like for United States of America, this Federal Reserve is the central bank, and the head of Federal Reserve is Janet Yellen, and popularly known as the Fed Chair. And there is lot of talk that Federal Reserve will increase interest rates, but they have not increased interest rates. There are several reasons for it. I have listed here. First and the foremost is global financial and growth situation. The world is not growing on the expected lines. Second important point is, if you look at the USA in particular, exports are falling continuously since October 2015, and exports in overall terms fell by 5%. And third important point is, employees' wage growth is not improving. Though the unemployment figures are satisfactory, that means unemployment is kept at much lesser levels, but the employee wage growth is not improving. The fourth important point is, initially USA projected that it will grow at around 2.4%, but it is not able to realize its potential, and now it is expected that USA will grow at around 2.2%. That means it is not expected to grow at the initial forecast figure of 2.4%. That means the growth in USA itself is not on expected lines. Fifth important point is, inflation. For developed countries, not having sufficient inflation is the problem, and for USA, inflation is around 1.2%, but developed countries, the goal is to have inflation of 2%. Please don't forget, for developing countries, inflation is the problem. We are suffering from high inflation, but developed countries are suffering because of not having inflation. It is the irony, and developing countries suffer because of high inflation levels, whereas developed countries suffer for not having sufficient growth, for not having sufficient inflation. So, because of all these reasons, United States of America finally decided not to increase interest rates because growth is not on the expected lines. Look into the next issue. Punjab Assembly unanimously passed Punjab Settlers Yamuna Link Canal Rehabilitation and Revesting of Proprietary Rights Bill 2016. What is the purpose of this bill? The bill was passed by Punjab Assembly, and the purpose of this bill is to return back 4,000 acres acquired for this Settlers Yamuna Link Canal, popularly known as SYL. And let us go back to history. This Settlers Yamuna Link Canal is 212 km length, passes through Punjab and Haryana, and please don't forget, prior to 1966, Punjab and Haryana were only one state, and in the year 1966, based on linguistic lines, Haryana was separated from Punjab, and this SYL canal is basically with regard to sharing of Ravi Bias waters to Haryana, right? And most of the issues were settled in 1970s and 1980s. In fact, foundation stone was laid in 1982. Canal works progressed, part of the work was done, and the crisis suddenly started in the year 2004 when the Punjab government passed the Punjab Termination of Agreements legislation. At that time, Congress government was there in both the Punjab as well as at the center. At that time, Punjab government passed Punjab Termination of Agreements legislation. Subsequently, a presidential reference was made to Supreme Court in 2004, and the matter is pending with Supreme Court for the past 12 years. And on 17th March of this year, Supreme Court ordered to maintain status quo. And on the very next day, on 18th March, Punjab Assembly passed the bill so as to give back land to the farmers. That means Punjab government passed the bill so as to give back 4,000 acres of land back to the farmers, and it is not in the right spirit as the matter is pending in Supreme Court, and Supreme Court on 17th March ordered to maintain status quo. That means don't touch anything till further orders are given. But on 18th March, Punjab Assembly passed the bill. And this is not in the right spirit of our democracy. Right friends, there are several disputes going on, river water disputes, and the government should devise the right mechanism to solve these types of disputes. Quite often all of you are familiar with Kaveri water dispute between Tamil Nadu and Karnataka, Mullaperiyar between Tamil Nadu and Kerala, and now this is between Punjab and Haryana. And there should be some mechanism to be devised by the center so as not to recur such incidences in future. Supreme Court allowed the photographs of governors, chief ministers and ministers on government advertisements. Supreme Court on May 13, 2015, in its order, permitted publication of the photographs of only the president, the prime minister and the Chief Justice of the country on government advertisements. On government advertisements, on May 13, 2015, Supreme Court allowed only President, Prime Minister and Chief Justice to appear on government advertisements. The basic reason is to prevent glorification of personality cult. The Supreme Court felt that glorifying a person in a democracy is not right. And accordingly, to prevent the glorification of personality cult, this decision was taken. But subsequently, Government of India as well as seven states approached Supreme Court for reviewing the order of May 13, 2015. And the Attorney General representing for the center felt that if the Prime Minister's photo is allowed, logically his cabinet colleagues' photos should also be allowed. And now the Supreme Court modified the order, and as per the modified order, in addition to the President, the Prime Minister and the Chief Justice, now the photographs of governors, chief ministers and the ministers of state governments or central government are now allowed to appear on government advertisements. Right friends, with this let us conclude Insight. Please do join for other modules, and from this week, you have one additional module on science and technology, health and environment. Right friends, have a nice day. Thank you.